Welcome to lecture 7. So we have been discussing symmetry elements and symmetry operations. So let us summarize what we have learned so far. So let us list down all the symmetry elements we have learned and corresponding symmetry operations, and if there are any special cases. So let's see symmetry elements. The first symmetry element is identity, followed by proper axis of rotation, which is symboled by CN, then inversion center, sigma, that's the plane of symmetry, and improper axis of rotation, right? Also called as rotation reflection axis. And the corresponding operations it will generate. So let's say number of operations. So E will generate only one operation. N order CN axis will generate N operations. I will generate only one operation. Sigma will generate only one operation. And SN will generate N operations if N is even. We have seen that. And it will generate 2N operations if N is odd, right? Also, there were some special cases that we have seen. If CN to the power N, this will be equal to E. I to the power 2N will also be equal to E. Similarly, sigma to the power 2N would also be equal to E. For if you take only S1, it is nothing but sigma. We can easily prove it. If you take S2, this is nothing but I. So you need actually N equal to 3 or higher for S3 to exist. So you can work this out yourself. So if you take N equal to 1, S1 becomes sigma. If you take N equal to 2, S2 becomes I. I have not shown it explicitly, but try to work it out yourself. Now, Sn to the power n equal to E for n even, and Sn to the power 2n equal to E for n odd, right? Okay, so this is the summary of what we have learned so far. So let us now look at some solved examples to help you understand how do we actually list down all the symmetry elements and corresponding operations in different molecules. So let us start with a typical molecule, let's say water. So we have been seeing water. So what are the symmetry elements present? So the very first element in every molecule that we have to list is identity. It is always there irrespective of the molecule, right? That as we have learned. In addition to E, so let's then look at what is the principal axis which is present. So principal axis which is present in this case is, there is only one axis, proper axis of rotation, which is C2 axis, which is lying in the plane of this board. So we can say C2, only one C2, so we will write only one here. Then there is one plane, which is the molecular plane, which contains C2. And another plane is the plane which is actually perpendicular to the plane of the board and reflecting the two hydrogens. So there are two planes, two independent planes, so we can call it as sigma V1 and sigma V2, right? Now how many operations it will generate? Let us see. So E will generate only one operation, E. Then C2, so C2 should generate two operations, C2 and C2 square. But C2 square is nothing but E, so we don't need to consider this one. So because we are considering only non-redundant operations. Okay. So we don't need to consider C2 square, although C2 will generate two operations, as we have learnt, nth order principal access will generate n operations, but we don't need to consider this because this is equivalent to A. Now sigma V1 will generate sigma V1, one operation. Every sigma will generate one operation. So we have sigma V1 and sigma V2. So total four symmetry elements and four operations. Okay, so this number is important. We will see later. Four operations that are non-redundant. Okay, so this was an easy case. So let us go to little higher number of operations. Let us see. Let us look at tetrahedral molecule methane. Okay, so now let's see what are the elements and then corresponding operations also we will list down. So first and foremost is always E. Now what is the principal axis of rotation here? So how many proper axes of rotations are present? So one is C3 axis, which is passing through CH bond. There are four such axes because there are four CH bonds, right? And another is C2 axis. So C2 axis is bisecting the HCH angle. We have seen this example before. This will be C2, right? So let's see, we can write down. So there are four C3 axes, all are equivalent. So I'm writing them together. If there are non-equivalent C3 axes, then you will write C3, C3 prime, C3 double prime and so on. But in this case, since all are equivalent C3 axes, because all CH bonds are equal. So that's why we are writing as 4C3. Now, how many C2s are present? So think about it. How many HCH bonds are there that are bisected? How many of such C2 axes will be there? So there will be three such C2 axes. So if we list them down by numbers, let's say 1, 2, 3, 4, it will be easier to see that for C2, let's say H1, C, H4, then H1, C, we have to take only non-redundant ones, H2, then H1, C, H3, right? These are the only options where the C2 will bisect, okay? Let's say if you are taking H1, CH4, H2, CH3 will be covered in this, right? So it is bisecting H1, CH4 as well as H2, CH3 angle, right? Now similarly H1, CH2, so this will be bisecting H3, CH4 angle, and H1, CH3 will be bisecting H2, C, H4 angle, and there are only six such angles in this tetrahedral molecule. So we have three C2s over here. Okay, so that's how we list them. Now, what else do we have? Any ideas? So we will have S4 axis. So what is an S4 axis? S4 is combination of C4 into sigma, right? Sigma, which is perpendicular. Okay, so can work it out this operation, try to work it out this operation yourself. Otherwise, we can discuss during the interaction session how many such C4s will be present. If there are three C2s, there will be three S4s present. Okay. Then we also have sigmas present. In this case, these will be called as sigma D's because these will be bisecting the H2C angles. And how many such sigma D's are present? There will be six such sigma D's. Okay. So let's also see where the sigmas are present. So let me draw this molecule over here again. So if I draw a plane which is containing, let me write down 1, 2, 3, 4. So containing H1, C, H2 and reflecting H3 and H4. So this will be one such sigma, and we have seen that there are six such bonds. So there will be six such sigmas, right? That is easier to see. Now the number of operations. So E will generate only one. Now each C3 will generate C3, C3 square and C3 cube. That means three. But now this one is equivalent to E, so we don't need to consider this one because E is already considered over here, so this is not required. So that means each of this C3 will generate two operations. So then we will have eight C3 operations. Okay. Now C2, each C2 will generate two operations, C2 and C2 square. Again, C2 square will be equal to E, so we don't need to consider this one. So that means there will be total three C2 operations. S4, we have seen that each S4 should generate N operations, right? Because N is even over here, so S4 should generate S4, S4 square, S4 cube, and S4 4. Now this will be equal to C4 into sigma. This will be equal to C4 square into sigma square, which is equal to C2. Okay, so this becomes non-redundant. This is not, because C2 is already covered over here. Then we have C4 cube sigma cube, which is C4 cube sigma. So again, this will be considered, and this is equal to E, right? So that means each S4 will generate two non-redundant operations. So that means we will write two S4s, and each sigma D will generate one operation. So we will have six sigma D's. So these are the number of operations it is going to generate. So that means total operations will be here. Sorry, 3 × 2, 6, right? Because we have each will generate two, so we have total three S4 axes, so this will be six. So 12 and 12, so 24 operations. Okay, so by now we should be able to identify where the symmetry element is located and how many symmetry operations it will generate. And this thing will come out only with practice, so you need to practice with a large number of molecules, otherwise this will never be very clear. And further down the line, the course will handle this thing as if you know how to calculate this. So you should better practice at this point itself, how to identify what are the symmetry elements present, locate their positions onto the molecule, and generate operations and identify how many symmetry operations are there. So let us see one more, or maybe a couple of more examples to confirm this. Now let's say the molecules which we have considered already. So BF3. Now again, what are the elements and the corresponding operations? So elements will be E, principal axis will be C3. Where is C3? C3 will be perpendicular to the plane of the board passing through boron atom. Then we have, how many C3s are present? Only one. Then we have C2s. Where is the location of C2 now? C2 is located passing in the plane of the board and passing through BF bond, right? This is C2. How many such C2s are present? There are three such BF bonds, so there are three such axes, right? So we have three C2s. What else? We have a molecular plane sigma H, then which will contain all four atoms. So this is my molecular plane. Then there will be three planes, each containing the BF bond and perpendicular to the plane of the board. So because it is containing the C2 axis as well as the C3 axis, so this will be called as sigma V. Now how many sigma Vs will be present? There will be three sigma Vs. Now what else is present in this case? Now you have noticed that there is a C3 present and a plane which is perpendicular to C3 is present. So that means there must be a S3 axis present, right? Now because there is only one C3, so there is only one S3. Now let us list down the operations. So by the way, you should try each and every operation and try to do the operation and see if you are getting an equivalent configuration of the molecule or not. So that will tell you whether the element is present or not. Okay. So now the operations E, each C3 will generate two operations. We have seen that earlier. So two C3 operations. Each C2 will generate only one operation because the C2 square will be equal to E. So we will have three C2s. Then sigma H, each will generate one. Each will generate one. S3, S3 square. So each S3 will generate two operations. So two S3. So now how many total operations we have? So we have 6, 7, 12. So 12 operations. Let's take one more example. Let us take cis or trans. Okay, let's do both. Trans 2-butene. Now elements and operations. So elements will be E. What else will be present in this case? We will have a C2 axis. Where will be the C2 axis? C2 axis will be perpendicular to the plane of the board and passing through CC double bond. So if you do this C2 operation, this will go there and this will come here, right? So that will be the kind of rotation, anti-clockwise actually, it will be like this. C2 and only one C2 axis. Then we have I. In this case, we will have I. So if you see here, this is the center of the molecule. So if you pass a line from one atom through the center of the molecule, you'll find the other atom. Similarly here, right? So you will have I, then we will have sigma H. So this is an easy case. Number of elements are very less in this, and the corresponding operations are E, C2, I, sigma H. So only four operations. Now let's also look at the case of cis-butene. Now what are the elements and what are the operations? So yes, E is the first one. Then what else we have got? We will have a C2 axis now. Where is the C2 axis? What is the location? C2 will be lying in the plane now, unlike this. So this is the C2 rotation. So CH3 will be moved to this CH3, H will be moved to this H. So this is my C2 axis. What else have we got? We will have two sigma Vs, sigma V1. So this is the case like water molecule. So one will be the molecular plane like this. This is sigma V1. And the other one is plane perpendicular to the plane of the board, but containing C2 axis, right? So it will be like this. Okay. So both the planes are perpendicular to each other, and each of this will generate only one operation. So again, four operations here. Okay. So with this, let us, I'll give you some home exercise so that you are comfortable with identifying all the symmetry elements and operations. So let's take benzene, let's take a square planar molecule XeF4, and let's take octahedral AB6, let's take a trigonal bipyramidal AB5. Let's take a square pyramidal AB5. So I will write it down. So square planar octahedral trigonal bipyramidal square pyramidal. We have already seen tetrahedral, so this will cover a full range. So if you can identify the symmetry elements and corresponding symmetry operations, locate the position of symmetry elements, and find out the number of total symmetry operations, you will be good for the rest of the course, because these are the type of molecules we will be dealing with very often. Okay, so try to practice this a lot so that this is very, very clear in the heads. So in the next class, we will be dealing with the product of symmetry operations, and then we will take up the definitions of symmetry group and all. Okay, so let's end the class today. Okay, thank you.